anonymity.
The most wonderful thing about living
is to be dead.
In what costume shall the poor girl wear to all tomorrow's parties?
Regrets? I've no regrets.
No, not at all.
No. Except that I was born a woman instead of a man. That's my only regret.
I've heard that one before, yes.
Just a perfect day. You made me forget myself. I thought I was someone else, someone good.
What he did do is he made it all possible. One, by his backing, and two, before we went in the studio, said, you've got to make sure, use all the dirty words, and don't let them clean things.
I think I would have been his wife. I mean, he'd had a long time to think about it, and he was going to speak with me. That was during my homeless period. I got more publicity when I became homeless than when I lived in my first husband's castle.
We all lived in loft buildings, and they were all old factories. Growing up in the art world, to a certain extent, art isn't anything special. It's what you do every day. One time I was in my father's loft and starving to death. I went down and I found some soup. And Al came home a little while later and asked me if I was hungry. And I said, no, I just had some soup. And he leaved the cans out of the garbage and said, do you know what this is? And I said, yeah, Campbell's the tomato soup. And he said, no, that's an Andy Warhol signature. You just ate two cans of Campbell's soup signed by Andy Warhol. So they say when you're really, really hungry, you know, food tastes great when you're really hungry. Let me tell you, it tastes even better when you're really hungry and it's art.
I don't care for pop art. I mean, when I was there, I thought it was gold. I thought it was fabulous. And I didn't understand what was going on. I just, you know, was one of the little flies on the wall going, oh, this is fabulous. Oh, wow. A soup can. Ha, 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 ha. And I hate it. Now.
Andy used to say, if you want to know about my paintings, if you want to know about me, just look at the surface of my paintings. That's all you need to do.
Silver factory, this, from this East 47th Street. Andy was the center. He was the force. You know, he said he was just there watching, paying the rent, you know, watching everybody else do things. That is, again, the opposite. It's like a huge magnet of ideas and exchange of ideas, and that's what life is about. And Andy, again, understood this.
Whoa, another kind of Andy Warhol. What, when you look at it, society in general, an overall aspect of society, what effect did Andy have aside from being just a large rock which was thrown into a pool and made a lot of ripples? The structure remains intact.
You go to Eisenstein, to Renoir, to Rossellini, nobody can make films like Renoir. Nobody can make films like Eisenstein, and nobody can make films like Andy.
When they tried to explain your film, they said this was a peek into hell. For me, William Burroughs' Naked Lunch is like a peek into hell.
No. Andy goes to church every Sunday. Andy could probably have his own idea about hell. Chelsea Girls remind you of hell?
No.
Were you surprised when critics wrote about that?
Yeah.
He used everybody around him to produce that whole body of work that cannot be repeated. cannot, nobody can repeat that.
And so I mastered the camera and used it for my artwork, you know?
But there was not really a place for me anymore, simply an art scene. So I left one day. And I left a note on the darkroom door, which says, "Dear Andy, I am not here anymore, but I am fine, love, Billy." And I went out into the world to see what the planet Earth was doing.
We were aware at the factory what we were. We could feel the power. We could feel the dynamic of the vitality of the whole thing being the hot spot in Manhattan, the center of the art world. But I really didn't have an intent to document. I was just a photographer or an artist who Andy gave a camera to.
Today, as an artist, I really rack my brain, my violet brain, to find out what shall I be doing? Because, you know, I know it's so transient and it's going to last 5 minutes or maybe 15 minutes if I'm lucky. You know, Andy, when he was much, much younger, wanted to be a tap dancer. And to be a tap dancer, you got to levitate from the ground. And Andy could not levitate from the ground. So he said, "Gee, I'm going to go into art, because there's no criteria in art. Anything goes."
I wish I could sing or hum.
Good hum, couldn't hum.
I don't know how to hum. I can't even whistle.
No, see, I'm way past my time, actually. But there's no one here anyway.
Here's my first poem, my first book, for which I was nearly arrested, before Allen and Ferlinghetti got arrested or anything. I have blown and been blown. I've never had a womb. I have been in great jails and terrible jails. The great jails were the tanks, and the terrible jails were the model prisons. I have seen my mother a few hours before she died. I have seen my father pinching pennies and felt it. I have heard and felt my father in his worship of money, worshiping money in the USA of money madness. Fuck it. I have been beaten nearly to death before an enlightened Greenwich Village crowd. I have been beaten in my hospital bed by sadistic doctors. I have played all the pianos that all the famous pianists have played in Carnegie Hall, in the basement of Steinway Hall, and I still play them after making it with the elevator boys on a quiet, religious Sunday afternoon. I have made goo-goo eyes at Marlon Brando with no luck, but not too much discouragement either. I have made it with Montgomery Clift in Central Park against a little pagoda, or at least he said it was Montgomery Clift, and it was Montgomery Clift.